Sterling. He has sold over 58 million records, received Grammy, Emmy, and Tony Awards, and now with his new CD, Manilow Sings Sinatra, he pays tribute to a classic. Please welcome my good friend and yours, Barry Manilow!
Oh, I've had more tea and more cough drops.
Are you all right?
Well, I feel okay. I just don't sound very good.
Yeah, you got a little like laryngitis, bronchitis.
It's laryngitis, it's bronchitis. It's I don't know. Where do you pick? I heard you had it for a while.
A month I had it for.
Oh, nice. Thanks a lot.
Yeah, I just got it two days ago,
and you know I was looking forward to so much to singing.
Yeah.
And there's a piano here, and there's microphones and people here.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Yeah, anyway. We'll see if we can work it out. Does it hurt?
Sometimes it hurts.
A little bit, yeah.
Did it hurt?
It hurt me, yeah.
Yeah, it hurts when you swallow and everything, right?
Right, right. Are you on some meds? You on some meds?
I'm on everything. They gave me shots. I'm drinking more tea. I'm peeing all afternoon.
Yeah, that's what happens, yeah. Now, the new CD, gotta say, I love it.
Have you listened to it?
I have listened to it, and it's Manilow Sings Sinatra is the name of the CD.
This was a risky thing to do, you know.
Really,
I did. Well, you know, it invites comparison to. That was comparison.
Comparison, he said. Everything.
To like the greatest singer of you know our generation of any generation, and but I didn't approach this sensibly. I approached it from the heart. I just wanted to say I don't know. After he passed away, I just felt like you know it was the end of a style of music. That I just didn't want to end yet.
Right.
And so I figured, well, you know, is there any way, what can I do? Is there anything I can do to say goodbye and thank you to this guy that opened the door for so many of us singers and stood for such great music? So I put together this great batch of musicians and arrangers, and I co-produced it with the great Phil Ramone, who did a few of Sinatra's albums. And we just had one last goodbye party, and it was a wonderful experience.
Were you friendly with him? Were you close to him?
I met him a couple of times. He was always really nice to me, very, very flattering. Yeah, I can't say I was like, you know, a good friend of his, but...
But he did help you in your career in some ways?
Well, you know, I heard that he said in the late 70s, they asked him, you know, what was going on in pop music, and he mentioned my name and he said he's next about me. And it was just at around the time when I had begun, like I started in 75 and right for the first 5 years, I mean, the critics were like brutal. They were like, they were brutal to me. And I was okay, guys. I had fans behind me. I had my record company behind me. But still, you know, you wake up in the morning, you read this crap.
Hurts,
oh, God.
Hurts.
You know, so, and then when Sinatra says, you know, he's next, I said, oh man, maybe I'm doing something okay, you know.
Right.
So I always appreciated that.
Where were you when you heard that he passed away?
I think I was in my car.
And is that really when you decided to do it?
No, I decided to do it about three months later.
Yeah.
I just, you know, I heard something, I heard like a record of his come on, and I said, oh, man. You know, if it hadn't been for Sinatra, I'm not sure that I would have known half the songs, like in the Wee Small Hours of the Morning, or, you know, any of these great songs. I think that kind of style of music would have been over in the 50s as soon as rock and roll came in. But he was just so... strong. He stood for such high musical standards that it kept going through every decade.
Was it hard to choose which songs to put on the CD?
Yeah, it was.
There's so many to pick from.
I went on the internet and I typed in Frank Sinatra, and somebody with entirely too much time has put in every song that he has ever recorded.
Really?
And it was like a catalog of the greatest songs of all time. So it was very difficult to choose.
Yeah. Now, are you very computer savvy? Are you an internet guy?
I'm not sure I'm an internet guy, but I do all my music on the computer. Yeah, I write everything, even for the new little Broadway show that I'm working on. I wrote everything and arranged it because I'm an arranger as well. And so
it was out in La Jolla, right, for a while? It was great, I heard.
Man.
Is it going to come into Broadway?
I think so.
It is? Well, good. I can hardly wait.
Yeah, it's called Harmony.
Harmony.
Harmony, yeah. It's fantastic. It was a fantastic experience in La Jolla. It's the true story of a group of singers in Germany during the 30s called the Comedian Harmonists, and my collaborator and myself told their story, and it's a fantastic thing. I hope it comes in next year.
I'm sure it will, and it'd be probably hard to get tickets because your concerts sell out in like 5 seconds.
Yeah.
You have the most loyal fan
base. I do.
I have been to so many... of your concerts that honestly, I feel like I recognize other audience members. I'm like, were you with the one in Radio City? They're like, yeah, I was there in Detroit. I'm like, I saw you. Do you ever do that? Look in the audience and recognize?
It's interesting to know your audience by their first name. I think I do.
Yeah.
I do, yeah. I see a lot of familiar faces. Well, you know, they've been with me. We've been together for a long time. But then again, you know, there's a lot of there's a lot of new faces out there, too. A lot of the younger people out there who are discovering things like Weekend in New England, and this one's for you, you know?
Right.
It's great.
And the best is when they have the signs, because you choose someone to come up to sing. Is it Can't Smile Without You? Is that what you sing with them? And people make these elaborate signs like they're on Let's Make a Deal. Neon lights and flashing glitter.
And people who have never seen it before, they don't know what to make of this audience. I mean, these people have come, you know, they're sitting there watching, and they're out of nowhere, signs and things come up. They don't know what to make of it.
Balloons and whistles. Barry, over here!
Right.
Ever have, what's the wackiest fan story you got? Any specific one?
I don't know. I don't think I have wacky fan story. Although I did get an interesting. It was a roll of toilet paper, and on the toilet paper, this gal had written, "You are my singer, you are my song," on every little leaf of the toilet paper. So I wasn't sure what to make of that.
Yeah, is that an insult or a compliment?
I'm not sure. Why did she choose toilet paper, I wonder?
And then did she have it put in your bathroom, or did she just
send
it?
No, I mean, she sent it. It was all nicely wrapped. It was, I don't know, it was kind of weird.
Kind of odd.
Kind of weird, yeah.
All right, now listen, you're not sounding that good, Barry.
I know, it's like getting worse, right?
What do you think? Should we try to do a song? Should you do a little?
Well, listen, we have
I mean, the CD is amazing. The CD is amazing. It really is.
I would love to try singing one, but I can't. There's no way I can hit these high notes. Would you like sit with me, and maybe you can hit the high notes. It'll be fine.
You want me to hit the high notes?
You'll hit the high notes. I mean, if I can, maybe I can.
Barry,
and if
remember
I can,
what we sang? We said you sang I write the songs and I wreck the songs.
I remember. Who can forget?
Oh well.
But try it. Come on, we'll try. During the break, we'll practice
okay.
Or something. Okay.
His new CD, Manilow Sings Sinatra, Barry with bronchitis, and me on the high notes.
Strangers in the night, exchanging glances, wondering in the night. What were the chances we'd be sharing love before the night was through? Thank you. Something in your eyes was so inviting. Something in your smile was so exciting. Something in my heart told me I must have
you.
A glance away, a warm embracing dance away. And ever since that night, we've been together, lovers at first sight, in love forever. It turned out so right.
You do it.
For strangers in the night.
Just a glance away, a warm